Welcome to a lesson on dividing whole numbers using area of rectangles. Let's first consider 48 divided by 8. This is asking us how many 8s are there in 48. If we think of this in terms of area, this is asking us how many rectangles of area 8 would it take to make a larger rectangle of area 48. To illustrate this, let's begin by sketching a rectangle with an area of 8. Let's go ahead and make the rectangle a 1 by 8 rectangle, which would look like this. This rectangle has a total area of 8 square units. To determine how many 8s there are in 48, we want to know how many of these rectangles it would take to build a larger rectangle with an area of 48. So let's start adding rectangles. Now we have a total of 3 rectangles, each with an area of 8, giving us a total area of 8 plus 8 plus 8, or 3 times 8, which equals 24 square units. Again, we're trying to build an area of 48 square units, so we'll keep adding rectangles. Now we have a total of 5 rectangles, each with an area of 8. 5 times 8 equals 40, so now we have a total area of 40 square units. So if we add one more rectangle here, notice how the larger rectangle would now have an area of 48 square units. So it took a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rectangles, each with an area of 8, to make a total area of 48, which means there are 6 8s in 48, so 48 divided by 8 equals 6. Let's go ahead and highlight this larger rectangle. Notice how the dimensions of this larger rectangle are 8 by 6, again giving us a total area of 6 times 8, or 48 square units. For every division problem, there's also a corresponding multiplication problem. So if 48 divided by 8 equals 6, again meaning there are 6 8s in 48, it's also true that 6 times 8 must equal 48. Which means 6 sets of 8, or 6 copies of 8, equals 48. Let's take a look at a second example. Here we have 63 divided by 9. We want to know how many 9s there are in 63. So again, using area, we want to determine how many rectangles of area 9 would it take to make a larger rectangle with an area of 63. So let's go ahead and make a 1 by 9 rectangle that would have an area of 9 square units. Notice how this rectangle does have an area of 9 square units. Now we want to determine how many of these rectangles it would take to make a larger rectangle with an area of 63. So let's start adding rectangles. Notice now we have 3 rectangles, each with an area of 9. 3 times 9, or 9 plus 9 plus 9 equals 27. But we want to have a total area of 63, so we'll keep adding rectangles. Now we have a total of 5 rectangles, each with an area of 9, giving us a total area of 45, so we'll keep adding rectangles. Now we have a total area of 45 plus 9, or 54, so notice if we add one more rectangle, we would now have a total area of 63 square units. And notice how it took 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 rectangles of area 9 to make a total area of 63, which means there are 7 9s in 63, and therefore 63 divided by 9 equals 7. Again, highlighting the larger rectangle, notice how the dimensions are 9 by 7, giving us an area of 7 times 9, or 63 square units. So if 63 divided by 9 equals 7, this also tells us that 7 times 9 equals 63, which means 7 sets of 9, or 7 copies of 9, equals 63. Next, we'll take a look at two examples where we have a remainder. I hope you found this helpful.